are what you love, I argued that we're not just brains on a stick. We're not just thinking things. We're not just these cognitive information processors. We're lovers. We're animated by what we long for and by what we desire. And in Awaiting the King, what I'm emphasizing is citizens are lovers. That you won't make sense of politics. You won't make sense of our public life if you just construe citizens as if they were rational information processors. If you won't understand politics if you think it's just the opportunity for people to express what they know and believe. You have to look at our public and political life as also caught up in these dynamics of desire and formation. In fact, it's very interesting. In Augustine's City of God, he says basically, we are what we love. He says what makes a people is precisely their orientation to the objects of their love. And he says, if you want to judge the character of a people, you have to read, you have to discern what they love. And for Augustine, that means you have to look at what people worship. And so in many ways, Awaiting the King is a liturgical analysis of what we worship politically, right? It's a way of coming to our public and political lives and saying, what are we devoting ourselves to? What are we giving ourselves over to? And as Christians, when we step into those spaces, what are we being trained to love? How are our desires being aimed in a particular direction? So this liturgical lens sort of gives us a new way to analyze our public, political, shared, communal lives in the territories in which we find ourselves. But the same lens, I think, also kind of reframes the stakes of Christian worship. And we realize that if worship is the civics of the city of God, this is the place where our loves are being trained to love what God wants for the world, to love God and to desire what God wants to see realized in our shared public life together. Thank you.